Hi, Krista. Good. Rainy. Yucky.
Do you have to pick up Artie or anything?
Are you sleeping up?
I know it was someone else.
I wonder who.
I think it was Kathy.
Yeah, what happened?
I don't know. I think there was some dirt. I think they were cleaning up the lint in the house. Maybe someone from New Bridges.
Oh,
so the Yankee game is delayed due to rain. They're going to play a night game, same night as the Mets.
Oh, okay. So they were saying
they have early. Yeah, on Channel 11.
So your
day was good? Your day was good, was busy. Did a lot of stuff, got a vitamin deals. And I saw the new Captain Marvel trailer.
Oh, did you?
It's amazing. So I guess already doing laundry today, right? Game of Thrones won, and they had a marriage proposal.
Oh, really?
On the Emmys. Like one of the producers, the winner of the Oscars, got one the Oscar winner. The winner of the state proposed to his wife on live TV. They say ratings were down because of politics.
Hey guys.
Oh,
maybe. Did somebody leave this here? Is this yours? You?
Yeah.
It's like a finder keepers kind of thing? No, I'm just kidding. Did you see that last night? Yeah, my head's still spinning. $100,000. And the winner didn't even have a photo. That's pretty baller. That really hit the target. Hashtag sponsor. And hats off to Papa Scott. He's taking a well-deserved high holy day off. Yom Kippur is about to begin, and I couldn't be happier to be here to fill in. Straight out of LA, I'm your host, a man with the face of Mark Zuckerberg, in the spirit of a free AOL dial-up CD, David Magadoff, the only David Magadoff on Earth. Shoutouts! Hi to Kate and Matt at SVS, whose budding romance started by playing HQ. Love that! To Holly and Helen at Hallmark, alliteration. And Stephanie Escobar, who saw one of my commercials. Love you, girl! You following us on Twitter? Follow us on @HQTrivia to make shoutouts, hang with other HQers, message certain HQ hosts funny animal gifs? Is it gifts? Write it in the comments, let us know. We kinda need to know. You can bing it, sure, but let a person tell you how to win. I'm gonna ask you 12 technological questions ranging from easy to hard. You got 10 seconds to tap the correct answer. You get them all right and you win. Remember to invite your amigos to get an extra life. They'll help you win. You can use one each game, but not on the last question. Use that supercomputer that God gave you. Brain power, baby! Woo! On September 13th, 2018, I was pre-approved for a loan for my new iPhone X. I have an actual credited loan for a phone, and that's kind of amazing. But you, oh you, could just buy it outright if you win all the $2,500 we're giving away today. And that person who won last night can just buy a Tesla and call it a day. Or just call it question one. The largest tech firm in existence is named for what fruit? Raisin, durian, apple. Something about completing a purchase with Raisin Pay doesn't ring as well in the ears. They probably made a solid choice going with apple. Apple is our answer, but you guys knew that. Taking a big old bite out of question number one. We got 200,220 of you, so even, and 760 getting that right. Q2. What device calls up internet service providers? Tandem, Diadem, Modem. Remember Prodigy? A big yellow box. It was the Cheerios of the internet. Raise your hand if you remember the sounds of dial-up modems. Actually, don't do that. Instead, you should have used your hand to tap the right answer, which was modems. Modems was the answer. Of course, we knew that because we're all on the internet. 217,090 of you got that right. Give yourselves a little high five hug right there. Shall we move on? Shall we move on? Cause I can show you the world. Specifically this Thursday at 9 for a Disney-themed HQ game. And if you have other plans that night, let it go, let it go. Okay, we're good. Question number 3. Which of these items is most likely to access the Internet of Things?
Did you say something?
Koosh ball, smart refrigerator.
They lost.
You know, the IoT is not a place for us mortals to hang around. This is where all the data goes about how you like your coffee and ice cubes and ambient light, as determined by your smart appliances like the smart refrigerator. Smart refrigerator was the answer, and you guys are super smart. That's why 160,739 of you guys got that right. Shall we keep going? I think so. Question 4. What does the V stand for in the online technology VOIP? Video, virtual, or voice? You know, I'm still wrapping my head around the idea that YouTube is free, but phone calls, which are just audio, cost anything at all. Especially after the invention of this voice over internet protocol. Voice is our answer, he said with his voice.
Not a good day to walk around the lake.
2,192 of you guys got the answer correct. Look at yourself in the mirror and give yourself a big smile as we move on to question 5. Google's Silicon Valley campus shares a name with what? Algorithm, memory unit, number. Down in Mountain View, California, or up in Mountain View, California, depending where you live, 3 million square feet of office space comprise the Google complex, or the Googleplex, named after the number I don't recommend counting to. Number it is. That's our answer. Our answer is number for number 5. 31,837 of you guys got that right. Well done. We're moving on to question 6. On a typical laptop, which of these identifiers is also known as a physical address? Internet login name, MAC address, or IP address? Hey, follow me now. Somewhere deep inside your laptop is a unique identifier that is most often called a media access control address, aka MAC address, aka Geeks for the Win! MAC address it is. 19,645 of you guys got that right. That means you're gonna move on. Yeah, moving on to question number 7. What does the S stand for in modern smartphone SIM cards? Subscriber, satellite, or system? That's a lot of in there. If you have a smartphone, and I know you do, and that smartphone gets service, and I hope it does, you are probably a subscriber to a service, and your phone is thusly identified by a subscriber identity module. Subscriber it is. You got it. 14,207 of you guys got that right. Looks like you guys know your subscriptions to your SIM cards. Moving on, question 8. Early phone hackers could get free calls using a toy package with what food? Cookie Crisp, Cap'n Crunch, Apple Jacks. There's a tall carton of almond milk when you need it. And it's also my nickname. In the 60s, a 2600 hertz tone could fool the phone company. Just cover a hole on the plastic whistle that the Cap'n Crunch gave out. Yeah, Cap'n Crunch is our answer. So many of you have avoided the soggies, 10,010 of you got that right. I'm feeling question 9, so what the heck, let's just get to it. An early 90s competitor to the World Wide Web was named for what animal? Squirrel, gopher, or mole? Now, this is a very cute question. Can we just sit back and enjoy that for a second? Back when graphical interfaces were brand new, finding what you wanted was done through hierarchical menu searching called Gopher! Gopher it is! Just a cute little gopher. 8,972 of you guys, you know your gophers, so let's go for it. Question 10. What single key opens a find field in the Firefox browser? A lot of F's there. Slash, comma, period. While your brutish Paleolithic coworkers are still using two fingers to hit the Control F for a search, you can be halfway done with yours by hitting the slash key. Guns N' Roses for the win. Slash is our answer. 5,184 of you guys got that right. Well done. So let's move on to question 11. Boop, boop. Which of these tech companies was founded by selling seafood by the seashore? Sega, Nintendo, or Samsung? Yeah, this may seem like arcane knowledge, but lots of nerds, including me. Now, Nintendo started as a playing card maker, and the fact that Sega originally stood for service games, and thusly, you don't need to know anything else about Samsung. It's Samsung for the win. Samsung was it. Oh, 2,917, you got that right. But over 4,000 of you guys, roughly 3,000 of you guys got that wrong. I'm calling it a savage question. It's a savage question. Ah, Dios mío, es pregunta de savage. It's a savage garden savage question. Like I said, about 3,000 of you guys got that wrong. I'm sorry, guys. See you later. Goodbye. Play your Segas. I am truly, madly, deeply sorry for you. My second game I ever hosted, we had a tiny glitch, aka the Brooklyn Tornado. It was scary and cool, like seventh grade. And I talked for like 60 seconds about pets and animals. I got so many bird tweets from you guys, and I thought to myself, this is why I love technology. And I know you terrific techies do too. So here we go, the final question, number 12. A mobile game called Send Me to Heaven was banned from the App Store thanks to what secret objective? Destroying phones, intoxicating users, or cult recruitment? Whew, all of those are kind of crazy. So, the object of this game was to rack up the highest score possible by, are you ready for this? Throwing your phone as high in the air as you could, then catching it, which carried a very expensive penalty. Destroying phones is the answer, but not for you right now. Keep your phone as is, because you just destroyed HQ Trivia. Yes! Yes, my winners. 1,875 of you guys got that right. So exciting. I hope you just know each other or find each other through the internet. Just use your technology, use your Mac addresses, all the things you learned. Hop on some Sega, Nintendo together, whatever it is, you're a winner. W-I-N-N-E-R. Let's check some of you guys out. We got Swifty US with a $1.33, a little black cat, and Jamagyar with a red cool car there. Someone having a little pit fire, a Gump nerd. Does that mean you're a nerd for Forrest Gump? I hope so. I really hope so. Broom Crimed as well. A little Pump 523. Looks like a dad with his son, both wearing the same t-shirt. I wish my dad and I could wear the same t-shirt together. Dad, let's get t-shirts together. Hi, holy moly day, HQties. You done good. I don't think you got much to atone for during Yom Kippur tonight. So just give yourself a double tap for a job well done. I've been your host, a man so white, my favorite movie is a TED Talk. It's me, David Magadoff, the only David Magadoff on Earth. I'll be seeing you again tonight at 9 p.m. Eastern for more HQ Live. Peace out, Cub Scouts. Hey guys, any of you have Hotmail on your phone? What? Oh, no, that's a joke. I don't actually have that. Stop looking at me like that.